trusts Solicitor General Jose Calida to drop a bombshell each time he faces a big case before the Supreme Court. During his defense of the government's position on the constitutionality of the Anti-Terrorism Act, he red-baited former Bayan Muna Representative Nery Colmenares when he linked him in a raid in Santa Rosa, Laguna, as among the government's victories against communist rebels.
Likewise discovered in the armory were subversive documents, streamers, campaign paraphernalia of Congressman Colmenares, Bayan Muna, and Gabriela, and training materials on advanced revolutionary warfare.
Witnesses and activists who previously occupied the Santa Rosa office raised doubts as to the recovery of firearms and explosives. Colmenares himself did not let it slide.
What's the use, Your Honor, of mentioning my name? This is red tagging then in the end. Your Honor, if in ordinary times red tagging may be considered a libelous statement. But now, Your Honor, red tagging is a deadly offense. It is a threat to life, liberty, and security. The fact that our paraphernalia, if true, were found there, it does not mean we're terrorists. And mentioning us in the opening statement implicates us in that crime, and that is very dangerous for us, Your Honor, and another type of red tagging.
In his opening statement, Calida cited 16 grounds why the petitions against the Anti-Terrorism Act should be dismissed outright. The passage of the law, he says, is a political question which the court cannot look into. It is an exercise of police power to protect the welfare of the people, and the petitioners questioning it have not suffered any direct injury for them to have any standing to challenge the law. Calida even cited effects in formal requisites such as verification and certification. He warned nullifying the law will compromise the country's international economic commitments and will endanger our economic survival. Calida was referring to the anti-money laundering provision under the ATA on the freezing of assets of designated terrorists.
Terrorism must be outlawed in all civilized nations, not explained or rationalized, but fought on and eradicated. My mission as Solicitor General is to see to it that the Anti-Terrorism Act will not be derailed by 37 frivolous lawsuits. Outright dismissal is the only choice available in this case.
But it wasn't Calida himself who faced interpellation by Associate Justice Rosemary Canandang, the only magistrate who managed to ask questions so far. Two of Calida's associates bore the brunt of the questioning, quizzed from the definition of terrorism and inciting to terrorism to arrests and detention under the law. Canandang did not go easy on the issue of giving law enforcers wide discretion in interpreting the law, citing various hypothetical situations.
You are in effect admitting that from the example given, the enforcement officers are now given such a wide discretion in apprehending the suspects based only on his own perception of terrorism.
If that police officer does not have personal knowledge on the intent of that person, he can only apprehend him for violation of common crimes, Your Honor.
Despite the OSG's initial position that the government does not conduct surveillance prior to a court authorization, Canandang managed to have the assistant soldier admit that there is informal surveillance.
Again, is it the government position that no surveillance can be done without the CA authorization?
Yes, Your Honor. As provided for in section, this is one of the safeguards provided for by the ATA. This is provided for in section 16, that no surveillance can be undertaken unless there is a written authorization from the Court of Appeals.
Distinguishing this from the informal surveillance being conducted, which is the basis of the intelligence reports gathered.
Yes, Your Honor. This is communication surveillance, Your Honor.
Canandang also sought clarification on the effect of designation.
Designation per se, Your Honor, cannot lead to an arrest or detention. But this without prejudice to the eventual filing of a prescription case, Your Honor.
I think you are not ready to answer this, but I think the question of the court is very clear. You clarify that in the memorandum that the government will submit.
And if the Anti-Terrorism Council can authorize arrest?
Law enforcers would arrest by virtue of a valid warrantless arrest following the guidelines set forth by Rule 113. If the law enforcers have already effected the arrest and they think that they could not file or the evidence are not yet sufficient for them to validly file a case before the prosecutor's office, then they would have to secure a permission from the ATC so that to detain the person arrested beyond the period contemplated by Article 125 of the revised Penal Code, Your Honor.
So that's the position of the government?
Yes, Your Honor.
And that is not to what is written in the law.
Tuesday's oral arguments was the first conducted online and also Chief Justice Alexander Resmundo's first as top magistrate. The oral arguments will resume on Tuesday. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.